Good morning, everyone. Let's wait just a couple of minutes. Okay, let's start. Can you hear me?
Yes. Yes.
Okay, very good. So, in the our last class, we agreed that sign representation of integers when first I will draw sign representation of integers in the 8-bit representation, 8-bit memory, when first cell we will give two sign and in the other cells we will write down binary number, it's not good representation because we lose here memory because we have there two zeros and moreover for machine, it's more easy to make addition than subtraction. That's why in computer representation of integers, they are used not representation with sign, when first cell we give to sign, but they are used two's complement. No. What is idea of Tush complement? I think all of you know what is odometer. Odometer, this is device, it's in any car, which measures distance. Mistakenly, people call them speedometer, but in fact, speedometer, it measures speed, and here in the speedometer, located odometer, and odometer, it measures distance traveled by car. Now, let's now imagine that in the odometer, there is written number 600,000. Now, I'm giving this example to explain what is idea of Tush complement. So let's imagine that in the odometer, here we have number 600,000. Okay. What do you think? What happens with odometer if you pass?
Okay, I missed the first few minutes of this. What's an odometer?
Oh, David, very good question. Odometer, David, it's in every car. And people mistakenly call it speedometer, but speedometer, it measures speed. And odometer is in the speedometer. It's located in the speedometer and it measures distance traveled by
car. How many miles? It's the thing that measures how many miles someone travels.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Okay, 1 million miles.
Yes, there is possible to show total 6 nines. Six nines.
Oh, okay. So if there's a maximum number of slots, then it's nine, then this would not show a million. The display would show 999,999 miles.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely, dude. So, if we imagine that in the speedometer there is 600,000 meter and car pass extra 400,000, what we will see in the odometer? Car passes 1 million kilometer or miles. But what we'll see, what we will see in the odometer when after 600,000 kilometer, car passes 400,000 kilometer. What we will see in the odometer? In the odometer, there is four digits, there is six place. There is place for six digits. So 600,000 plus 400,000.
We will see only nines.
It's 1 million. But in the odometer, Georgi, in the odometer, there is place only for six digits. That's why we will see just zeros. Do you agree?
Yes, I understand.
Yes, we will see just zeros. So this is, so result, when we add 400,000 to 600,000 is for machine, it's the same as if we will subtract from 600,000. If we will subtract, if we will add negative 600,000 kilometers, result is the same. And in this case, this number 400,000 each called first complement of this number. This is first complement. First complement of negative 600,000. I would like to emphasize that there are no standardized terminology. And sometimes, in some books, in some literature, first complement, this 400,000, it's indicated as first complement of not negative 600,000, but this positive 600,000. But it's just terminology. Idea of first complement is absolutely the same. So, what is first complement? I would like to ask you to, if any questions, ask before. It's very important how we got now. What is idea of first complement? So
I didn't really understand it.
Let's say again. So in the odometer, for example, there is 600,000 and car passes extra 400,000. In the odometer, you will see in the odometer, you will see only zeros. In the odometer, you can see only zeros. Just a minute, I will switch off my phone. Can you hear my board?
Yes, we can hear you.
Can you hear me, but can you see my board?
No.
No.
I will see again.
We can see now.
Okay, thank you. So this 4,000, it's first complement of 600,000. And there is no standardized terminology. And sometimes this 400,000 is called first complement of negative 600,000. But I think it's more easy to understand, and it's more clear if we will call first complement, if we will call 400,000 first complement of this number, negative 600,000. Okay, now let's now go back to our binary representation, and let's discuss when we have 8-bit memory. And idea is absolutely the same when we have 8-bit memory, 16-bit memory, or it does not matter. So when we have 8-bit memory, now, in 8-bit memory, to represent integers, we will use first complement. And now I will explain how we will use it. First complement, we need only for negative numbers. As for positive numbers, we will use ordinary representation and biggest positive number in 8-bit memory, we can write as 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. And what is correspondence number to this number?
127.
Absolutely. Because we know that seven ones, it's 2 in the power 7 minus 1. And this is 127. Okay, very good. For negative integers, we will use 2's complement. But first, let's give more clear definition what is 2's complement. To give this definition, first of all, let's agree that 2 in the power 8 in computer arithmetic, 2 in the power 8 is the same as 0. And what I mean? I mean that 2 in the power 8 is 1 and 8 zeros. And in the 8-bit representation, we will see only zeros. So we should agree about it. And then I will give definition what is 2's complement of negative number A. Is it clear for you that 2 in the power 8 in 8-bit memory, it's the same as zeros? Why? Because 2 in the power 8 in the binary system, 2 in the power 8 in the decimal, you know it's 256 decimal, but in the binary system, it's 1 and 8 zeros. Okay, now what is 2's complement? What is 2's complement for negative number A? Let's A be negative number. 2's complement for negative number is 2 in the power 8 minus absolute value of A. Let's compare again with our odometer. Let's compare with our odometer. So as we told, 400,000 each 2's complement for negative 600,000. And here we have 1,000,000. So this 400,000 I can represent as 1,000,000. Minus absolute value of negative 600,000. I have here no place. So this is definition of 2's complement. Okay. Now, for example, we want to represent negative 1 as 2's complement. Okay. What will be 2's complement of negative 1? 2's complement of negative 1, to find it, it's
1. 2 minus the absolute value of negative 1.
255.
Let's count it. So it's 2 in the power 8. Minus absolute value of negative 1. And it's going to be 255. Andrew is absolutely right.
Okay. How did we decide I am still confused about this. How did we decide 2 was going to be to the power of 8? Why did we decide that? Why
is 2 to the power 8? Which one, David? 2 in the power 8?
Why is the formula like this? Why is it 2 to the power of 8?
Do you mean this formula why?
Yeah.
Its definition. Its definition of 2's complement.
Okay.
Just definition. And why it's good to represent negative numbers as 2's complement? We will,
because computers can't deal with it.
We'll see it now. So look now. What is binary representation of 255?
Just 8 ones.
Yes, Andrew is absolutely right. It's 8 ones. We told about it because it's 2 in the power 8 minus 1. And we discussed it in previous class. And we have the same. For example, when we have 2 in the power 3 minus 1, it's in the binary system, it's 3 ones. It's just example. So I agree with Andro absolutely. And so now we have just found that negative 1 in the binary system, we can represent as all zeros. One. Okay, now I would like to emphasize.
Wait, minus one is all ones in the 8-bit system?
Yes. So these eight ones, this is 2's complement of negative number 1. I would like now to emphasize and pay your attention that this first one, it's not because it indicates sign. No, it appears here naturally because 2's complement of negative 1, it's 255. And 255 in the binary system, it's 8 ones. Okay, so biggest negative number, you know it, biggest negative integer, it's minus 1. And minus 1, we represented it in the binary system as 8 ones. Okay. Now, what do you think? How can we represent negative? What is smallest number? What we can represent? Any idea? So we know.
Depends on what you mean by smallest. Zero.
-128.
So Salome's idea is that it's minus 128.
I think it's zero.
Or zero, it's not negative, David. Okay. Zero is zero. It's not negative, it's not positive.
Yes, but it is the smallest number. It's literally nothing. Literally.
But my question is, which smallest number we can represent in the 8-bit system? And Salome's idea is that it's negative 128. Salome, can you explain it?
So when there were 2 zeros and we subtracted 1. So when we divide 255 into two parts, there were 2 zeros in the first complement. So when we subtracted 1, so minus part increased only once. So, and plus part was 126.
Okay, I got it, Salome, I got it. Let's check. Can we represent? And what will be representation? Salome, do you have any idea what will be 8-bit representation of this number, -128?
It will be a 100s, and last one will be 1, maybe, or not.
Okay, let's check, okay? So we have -128, and we want to represent it as 2's complement in the 8-bit representation. So let's first find 2's complement in the decimal system. 2's complement is going to be 2^8 minus negative absolute value of -228. What is it?
128?
It's 128. So this 128, this is 2's complement of -28. And how can we represent 128? Oh, no, sorry. Yes, and how can we represent 128?
Zero and seven ones.
What is 128? Which power of 2 is 128?
7.
7.
2^7. And how can we represent in the binary system 2^7? How can we represent in the binary 2^3?
2^7
is going to be 0. It's 1 and 3 zeros. Or if you need more support, how can we represent in the decimal system 10^3? 1 and 3 zeros. How can we represent 10^7? 1 and 7 zeros. So 207 in the binary system is going to be 1 and 7 zeros. Okay. Now, any questions so far?
What if the binary value of a negative number and the binary value of a positive number are the same? How would a computer distinguish them?
Oh, very, very good question, David. Very good question. So, you mean when in the computer we have, for example, number 1101100. For example, computer, how can computer distinguish this is positive number or negative number? You know, positive numbers. Let's first define what is the range of representation in the 8-bit memory. What is the range of representation numbers? Range of representation numbers, if we have seen, it's from -28 to +127. This is a range. And by the way, how many numbers we can represent using 2's complement? Do you remember when we used sign magnitude representation, when first cell we gave 2 sign and other cells, in the other cells we wrote down binary number, we could represent only 255 numbers because we had there 2 zeros. But in this case, when we use 2's complement, let's count how many numbers we can represent. 128 negative numbers, 127 positive numbers and 0. 1 0. So totally, in total, we can represent 256 numbers. And about range here, we have, I can write in the powers, it's minus 2 in the power 8 to 7 and 2 in the power 7 minus 1. It's when we have 8-bit representation. In general, if we have L-bit, range, which numbers we can represent? It's minus 2 in the power L minus 1, 2 in the power L minus 1, minus 1.
But so, in this case, first digit always represents a sign or not?
No, no, Andro. I emphasized it that in this representation here, in this representation, and we, do you remember, we by 8 ones, we got that this is representation of negative number minus 1, and this first one, it's not indicate sign. It appears naturally, this one, because negative numbers.
So in the system, there would be
David, just a minute, I'm answering your question now. Look, range of 2's complement of negative numbers, it's from 127, 128 to 156. This is range of 2's complement of negative numbers. Because do you remember what was our first negative number? Smallest negative number. What was our smallest negative number?
-128.
Yeah. So here is 255. Yes. So for smallest negative number, we have to complement 255. For biggest, we have 128. Biggest, I mean absolute value. So this is range. This is range for 2's complement of negative numbers. Let's explain again why it's range. Because for first negative number, it's minus 1. For minus 1, 2's complement is 255. And for smallest negative number, for smallest negative number is 128. 2's complement is 128. We calculated it. So this range from 128, 255, this is a range of 2's complement. And all these numbers from 128 to 255, in the binary system, all of these numbers have 8 digits. 8 digits, and it means first digit is 1. That's why in the 8-bit representation, there appears, that's why I told that this first one, it appears naturally. naturally, I mean that it appears in this example, in this case, for example, it appears because these eight ones, it represents number 255. And we can do it for any negative number. For example, if we want to represent negative 5, we need to find 2's complement of negative 5. And what will be 2's complement of negative 5? It will be 200, let's write down it in the power, 2 in the power 8 minus 5 absolute value. And it's going to be 251. So if we will convert 251 into binary system, first digit will be 1. That's why I told that this first one, it not indicates sign, it indicates negative number because this is 2's complement.
Yes, but it's in case of 2's complement. But what if we don't know if it is 2's complement or it's just 8-bit number? So you mean?
No, Andro. I mean, how can you distinguish? For example, you have 2 numbers.
Yes, I can represent more than 128 number in 8-bit numbers. Yes,
you can't represent it. Yes.
But you it can be negative or just positive and more than 128.
You can't represent it because there is a range. There is range which number we can represent in the 8-bit. In the 8-bit, Andro, in the 8-bit memory, we can represent numbers only from negative 128 to 127. If you have positive number more than 127, you can't represent it in the 8-bit memory. You need more memory.
But we have 8 places for numbers.
Yes, we have 8 places, and that's why.
And yeah. In that case, first place always must be 0. Because
yes, absolutely right. In this case, first place always is 0, but I can say the same. This 0, it's not indicate sign. It appears naturally because all positive numbers from 1 to 127, all positive numbers, in the binary system, these numbers, all these numbers have 7 digits, less than 7 digits. To be more exact, less than 87 or less.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why they naturally appears 0 in the first place.
So we can use unless merve biti ertiani ro davtserot ashegvizlia mag shemtkhovashi tu rogor aris.
Ertiani andro.
An tavshi ro ertiani davtserot nulis magira da mere 7 ragats ertebi ar nulebi davtserot ashegvizlia.
Ashnishnars andro ai aba kargat mitkhare.
Ანუ 1 0 და მე რავი 6 1-იანი კიდე დავუშვათ, ეგრე რო დავწეროთ. ანუ ხო იქნება 127-ზე მეტი.
აა, არა, არ შეგიძლია, იმიტომ რომ ის უკვე ის აღარ არის. It's not positive number. Yeah, it's not positive number. You can represent positive numbers only 127. If you will write down 1 and 1 1 1 and 7 0, it will be greater than 127.
Yes. Okay.
Okay. Now, what are practical ways? What are practical ways to find 2's complement of number? What are practical ways to find two's complement of negative number? For example, we have number negative 33. And we need to find two's complement of this number. We know how to find it by definition. By definition of two's complement, but now I will show more simple way, more easy way to find two's complement. So step one here is to find absolute value of this number. It's very easy. Then this number represent in the binary system. And if we will represent this in the binary system, so it's in the decimal system, and binary representation of this number is going to be 1. I think 4 zeros and 1. Why I decided? Of course, we can represent 33 as powers of zeros, but I decided that this is correct because I know that 32 in the decimal system, it's 1 and 5 zeros, and 33, it's 32 plus 1, and I just added 1. Okay. Now, next step is to write this number in the 8-bit memory. In the 8-bit memory, it means that we should write it in 8 place. And if it's necessary, we should add in front zeros. So here we have 6 digits. And I should add 2 zeros in front. This is second step. Next step is also very easy step. It's to flip these numbers. Flip, I mean zeros I will replace by 1, and 1 I will replace by zeros. So it's going to be 1 1 0 1 1 1 1 0. And finally, next step is to add 1. And our final answer is 1 1 0 1 1 1 1 0. And this number is 2's complement of negative number 33. Okay. Now, if given 2's complement, for example, given 2's complement, for example, given 2's complement, and we need to find correspondence decimal negative number. Here is a very frequently asked question. How can we know that this is 2's complement or ordinary binary number? Answer is, you can't determine it's 2's complement or ordinary binary number. It will be given that this is 2's complement. For example, in the exams, in the quiz, it will be given. This is 2's complement, and please find correspondence decimal number. So to find this decimal number, we will go backward. And do you remember what was in previous example, last step? Add one. So here, first step, it will be to subtract one. And we know how to subtract. And to subtract it, we will borrow one from here. And here is 0001 0011. This is first step. Next step is to flip this number. Flip so zeros I will one I will replace by zero, and zero I will replace and this number is binary number which corresponds these two's complement. And now we will find this number. So it's 1101111. This is in binary system. And now we will find this number. I think I made some mistake here. So we have 1101111 in the binary. Now I will represent it in the decimal system. So we have here 2. In which power we have 2? In the power 5 plus 2 in the power 4 plus, I will skip 2 in the power 3 and 2 in the power 2 plus 2 in the power 1 and plus 2 in the power 0. So now we will calculate this number. Can you help me? What will be this number?
Fifty-five.
Okay. Thank you, Luca. 55. So we can say now that.
But we have 33 from the beginning.
33 or 55. 2 in the power 5, it's 32.
I mean,
No, it's 55.
No, we can say that 55 is correspondence number of given this given two's complement, or to be more exact, but it's not exact, but the reason is just that there, as I told, there are no standardized terminology. In fact, this number, this given number, two's complement, correspondence number for this two's complement is not 55, but negative 55. But if you will write down only 55, it's not a mistake, because there are no standardized terminology. Okay, now.
How can we define positive or negative? How can we define positive or negative?
Salome, you know, as we told, this given number, two's complement. We need two's complement for only positive numbers. And idea is the same. Salome, look. What is this number? First, let's sketch what is idea. idea is that this number, if I will add this number to other number, result will be the same as I will subtract 55. So this is main idea. And in the answer, you will write that correspondence number is 55 or negative 55. None of them is mistake because there are no standardized terminology. But idea is the same. So this number means that result will be the same if I will add this number. Now I will show one small example. For example, how it works, these two complement. For example, I want to find 15 minus 30. We know very well that this is 2. Now let's find how it works. First, let's write 15 in the 8-bit representation. 15 in the 8-bit representation, in the binary, it's 4 ones, it's easy. Okay. And 2's complement for this. 2's complement, or not 2's complement, but in the 8-bit binary representation, this number is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1. I wrote down it in the 8-bit memory, 15. Now, 2 writes down negative 13. 2 writes down negative 13. In the 8-bit representation, we need to find 2's complement for this. 2's complement. And how can we find 2's complement? We have number of steps. What is step one? Find minus 13 absolute value. It's 13. Okay. Then represent this number in the binary system. Please help me what it will be. We can represent it as 8 plus 4 plus 1. So it's going to be, here is 2 in the power 3, 2 in the power 2, and 2 in the power 0. So we have 1, 1, 0, 1. Okay, now next step. I will write down it in the 8-bit representation. 0, 0, 0. We need to add 4 zeros because we need to complete 8-bit. 1, 1, 0, 1. Next step is to flip this number. And to flip this number, it's 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0. And final step is to add 1 here. And it's going to be 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0. So what I got now, this number, 2's complement of negative 13, and what it means? It means that if I will add this number to number 15, I should get 2. Because I know that 15 minus 13, this is 2. Now let's check it. Let's check it. So we know this is 8-bit representation of 15. zero, 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 one, 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 one. This is 8-bit representation of 15. And this is 2's complement of negative 13. And now I will use idea of 2's complement. Idea of 2's complement is that I will add this number to this number, 15, and result must be the same. Result must be, I should got number 2. Okay, let's try it. So I will write 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1. Now, I will add this 2's complement with this number. And let's add 1 plus 1, 0, carry 1. Here we have 1. Please look very critically, because if I make mistake, result will be different. So it's okay. Then here we have 1 and carry 1, 0. Here also in the same reason, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. So what I got in the computer? In the computer, I got this number. In the computer, I got this number. Let's check. This number is binary 10. And we know very well that binary 10, it's decimal 2. So what we did now that we used main idea of 2's complement. We added 2's complement to 15, and the result is the same if from 15 we will subtract 13. Okay, now it's time for quiz. I will now publish our quiz. And if you have any questions, please prepare your questions. And also in the next class, and not only in the next class, but I would like to remind you that every Tuesday from 12 to 2 p.m., I'm available on the Zoom. So you can anytime join me and ask any questions. So I will now publish our assignment, and our assignment is quiz 4. Okay, it's published and you can see. It's about how to represent binary number in the decimal number. To find 8-bit 2's complement for integer, for negative integer, and reverse problem, given 2's complement, and find given 2's complement, and to find correspondence decimal number. Please, you can start quiz.
I can't see the quiz on my page. Wait, hold on.
David, you should find it in the assignment section. Assignment.
Which
section.
One is it? Fourth one?
Yes, fourth. Quiz four. David, did you find it?
Yes.
Okay.
Ატონო ლექტორო, პირველი პრობლემა უბრალოდ ორობიტში გადაყვანა, მეტი არაფერი?
დიახ, ზუსტად მიხვდი ძალიან.
Should I do this on paper or can I submit it as a document?
Yes, too.
So I'll do the work on paper, then I'll submit the answers on a document. Is that okay?
Yes, it's okay.
Okay, that would be much easier. This.